Me, Boris says that if the weather is fine on Sunday, they're all going on an excursion to Vitosha. Why don't we join them, Mummy?
We may, dear.
Why we may? Let's decide it for certain. I like climbing mountains.
All right, Nelly. We'll go if Daddy isn't busy.
I'm sure he won't be busy. Even if he were, he'd leave his work for Monday. He loves picnics so much. Granny, we'll take the bus to the Golden Bridges. That's the most difficult part of the road. It's stony and very steep.
You have been up there, haven't you?
Oh, yes, several times. It's such a lovely place, the Golden Bridges. There are pine forests and small meadows full of flowers. There's a small stream too, but it's very fast and ice cold.
Are these bridges made of gold?
Oh, no. Mother told me once why they were called so, but I've forgotten. The name comes from the big boulders coming down from the mountain peaks like a stone river. At sunset, they look as if they were made of gold. That's why they are called Golden Bridges.
Hello, what's this about the Golden Bridges?
Tony, we're going on an excursion on Sunday.
What? On an excursion to the Golden Bridges? Ha ha, this isn't an excursion. Young lady, this is only a stroll for me.
Now, Tony, there you're boasting again. All right, you go to some high peak, and we'll go to the Golden Bridges on Sunday.
Hello, what's going on here? Who's going to high peaks?
It's Tony this time. Mountaineering is his latest hobby, and he's full of peaks, avalanches, glaciers, rescue parties and whatnot. He must have been reading a travel book lately.
Well, Nelly sent him off to his old high peaks because the Golden Bridges are beneath him.
All right, all right. But if we go to Vitosha, why not go on Saturday afternoon?
If we are going on Saturday, where shall we put up for the night?
But, Father, there are so many huts in the mountain.
Of course there are. But there are thousands of people who want to stay overnight in a hut on Saturday. Besides, many of the huts are turned into rest homes for the season. If you had mentioned it before, I would have booked rooms at a hut or a hotel. But it's Friday, and it's too late now.
If I had known, I would have told Lubin to reserve a room for us. He is the Aleko hut keeper, and a very good friend of mine. He was in Sofia yesterday.
I see there are too many ifs here. We'd better consider the matter without ifs, if we can.
Well, Julie and I can go on Saturday afternoon. We can find beds or benches at any hut, and we'll go down to the Golden Bridges on Sunday morning to meet you.
All right, boys, but if I were you, I'd take the lift.
Yes, Father, and then I know some short cuts that will lead us to the huts before sunset.
Well then, that's settled. We start right after school. Julie, shall we go to the Boyana waterfall in the evening? There's a small cave right behind the water and a beautiful view of the Sofia Plain.
If you don't stop talking about waterfalls, caves and going there in the evening, Mother'll get frightened and we won't go anywhere.
Ah, yes, I forgot. You call this tactics, don't you?
You think you're very smart, but just do as I tell you.
Isn't there any danger of losing our way without the boys?
Oh, no. I know my way about Vitosha. And even if I didn't, there are hundreds of people on the mountains on Sundays, and the paths are well marked. Besides, I know them as well as I know the streets in Sofia.
Now, Nelly, switch the radio on, will you? There's an excellent Tchaikovsky concert in 15 minutes.
Tony, don't forget to take your camera with you. We must take many snapshots this time.
Tony, I can never tell to which club you belong.
Why, I belong to no club. But Levski, of course, is my favourite team. I say, Julie, did you really think I meant to take Granny with me to the match?
No, of course not. It was...
Can you keep a secret?
You know I can.
Of course I didn't mean to. I know that Granny doesn't know a thing about football. But I had to find some way of drawing Father's and Mother's attention away from the fact that I had bought tickets without asking permission first.
Smart chap you are.
Do you think it was very wrong of me?
Well, not exactly. It wasn't a lie. It was what I call tactics.
You see, Julie, the tickets were rather expensive, and I'm short of money.